बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द प्रैक्टिकल फीडबैक सर्किट्स। आवर फर्स्ट सर्किट इज वोल्टेज सीरीज फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर। अगेन द फर्स्ट टर्म इंडिकेट्स सैम्पलिंग। सो एट द आउटपुट वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द वोल्टेज सैम्पलिंग, विच मीन्स दैट एट द आउटपुट वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द वोल्टेज। द सेकेंड टर्म इंडिकेट्स मिक्सिंग, एंड मिक्सिंग ऑलवेज टेक्स प्लेस एट द इनपुट साइड। And because we have series mixing over here, series mixing is also called as voltage mixing. It means that at the input side, we are again going to have the voltage. And also because we have series here, so the feedback and input signal is going to be in series. Feedback and input signal is going to be in series. Now, we have this voltage series feedback circuit where we have the N-channel JFET. This is my N-channel JFET over here. Now when we do not have a feedback, that is when we have feedback VF is equal to 0, suppose we have VF is equal to 0, then in that case when we perform the AC analysis, for performing the AC analysis, I am going to take this as ground. The DC sources is going to be grounded, so I am going to take this as ground, and this capacitor is going to be replaced by a short circuit. So I am going to replace this by a short circuit. Now the VF is also assumed to be 0, so we do not have this circuit connection. So this has been removed. In that case, if you can have a look, R0 is parallel to R1 plus R2, and then this RD is also parallel to this R0 because both are connected to the ground. So R0 is parallel to R1 plus R2, and that is parallel to the R0. Now that is parallel to the RD. So now let us call it as RL. Then gain without feedback is going to be equal to, let's suppose that is denoted by A, that will be equal to V0 by VI, because VS and VI will be the same because VF is equal to 0. So this will be equal to minus GM RL, where this RL is equal to R0 parallel to R1 plus R2 parallel to the RD. So this is my RL, and this is my equation for the voltage gain without feedback. Now when we connect the voltage, when we connect the feedback, then if we can have a look, this feedback voltage is equal to, in terms of R1 and R2, this is equal to VF is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into V0, which means that VF by V0 is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. But because we have negative feedback over here, this is my negative feedback. In this amplifier, we are going to use the negative feedback. So I'm going to place a negative sign over here because this VF is going to be my negative. Fine. So, and this VF by V0 is actually equal to beta. So I can say that beta is equal to minus R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Let's suppose this is my equation A. Now to find the gain with feedback, we have found the gain without feedback, which was minus GM RL, where RL is R0 parallel to R1 plus R2 parallel to the RD. Now to find the gain with feedback, we know that gain with feedback is equal to A divided by 1 plus beta A. Now if this beta A is very very greater than 1, this can be replaced by beta A. Then in this case, AF is going to be equal to 1 by beta, approximately equal to 1 by beta, and 1 by beta is equal to, which means that AF is going to be equal to minus R1 plus R2 divided by R2. So this is my gain with feedback for this circuit. Let me name it as equation B. Now why do we call it the voltage series feedback circuit? Now if we can have a look, the output is voltage, the input is also voltage, and if you can have a look, this feedback voltage is in series with the input signal. That is why it is called the voltage series feedback signal. So this is the gain without feedback, and this is the gain without feedback for this voltage series feedback circuit. Next circuit is the voltage series feedback using the operational amplifier. Now this is actually a non-inverting amplifier because the input signal is applied to the positive terminal of the op-amp. The input signal is applied to the non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. So this is actually non-inverting amplifier. And again, the feedback signal is VF, and this VF, because this is ground, so this VF is over here. And if you can have a look, this is connected in series because these two are going to be shorted out. So this is actually connected in series with this VS. That is why we say that the feedback signal and the input voltage are in series. So now we are going to find the beta for this. To find the beta, we know that this VF is going to be equal to R2 using the voltage divider rule divided by R1 plus R2 into V0, which means that this VF is VF by V0 is going to be equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. And this VF by V0 is actually my beta in this case, because in this case VF is going to be equal to beta times V0, because a sample of output signal will be taken and applied to the input. So VF is going to be equal to VF is equal to beta divided by V0. So this VF by V0 is actually my beta. So I can say that beta is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So this is my equation number A. So now this was my circuit of voltage series feedback using the operational amplifier. Next is voltage series feedback using the BJT, that is the bipolar junction transistor. So again, if you can have a look at the output, we are going to have the voltage, at the input we are going also going to have the voltage. So this circuit is going to be used for the voltage amplification. Also, this circuit, the output is taken from the emitter terminal and the input is applied to the base terminal. So this is our common collector BJT, or the common collector configuration. So this is our common collector configuration. This configuration is also called emitter follower configuration, because the voltage, the output voltage at the emitter will be approximately equal to the input voltage and also in phase. So this circuit is also called as emitter follower, and this configuration is common collector configuration. And this topology is voltage series feedback, because at the output we are going to have the voltage, at the input we are going to have the voltage. Also, this feedback and the input signal are connected in series. So these both are grounded, so I can simply connect them in series. So the feedback signal is in series with the input signal. Now in BJT, we know that the emitter current is approximately equal to the collector current. So now to perform the AC analysis, first of all, I'm going to ground this thing. So I'm going to connect a ground over here. And then to solve this, let us first solve the gain without feedback. So let us call that at A. Now when we do not have any feedback, that is when VF is equal to 0, we are going to have the VS is equal to VI. For VF is equal to 0, we are going to have the VS is equal to VI. We will find the gain without feedback in the moment. In this case, we have VS is equal to VI. So the gain will be equal to V0 by VI. And this means here the V0 will be equal to the current flowing over here, which is going to be the emitter current, and that will be multiplied by RE divided by the VI or the VS. Because VI is equal to VS, so I can write VI is equal to VS. Also in BJT, IE is equal to IC. So I can write over here that this is equal to IC into RE divided by VS. Now I can solve this by drawing the hybrid equivalent model. If you remember the hybrid parameters, the four parameters were very important. The input impedance, which was equal to HIE, the voltage feedback ratio, which was equal to HRE, the small signal current gain, that is beta, which was equal to HFE, and the output admittance, which was equal to HOE. So now in these two, the more important parameters are this input impedance HIE and the small signal current gain, that is beta. So beta is equal to HFE and the input impedance of the transistor is equal to HIE. So you need to remember these two parameters. Now you can draw the AC equivalent circuit of this amplifier using the hybrid parameters. This is grounded. So we are going to also have the RB over here. So this is going to be my hybrid equivalent circuit. This is the input resistance of transistor, which is denoted by HIE. And at the output side, IC is going to be equal to beta times IB. So this is IC current, which is equal to beta times IB. And that beta is equal to HFE. So I have replaced HFE over here. So this is now my AC equivalent circuit of this circuit. Now if you can have a look here, the IC is equal to HFEIB. So I can replace IC over here with HFEIB. So I'm going to replace the IC with HFEIB into RE divided by VS. Now from this equivalent circuit, this is my current IB. This is my current IB. And this IB is equal to, because we have VS source over here, this IB is equal to VS divided by the input resistance, which is HIE. So I'm going to replace IB is equal to VS divided by HIE over here. So let me replace IB with VS is equal to HIE over here. So I'm going to replace IB is equal to VS divided by HIE. Let me remove this and write it over here. So I'm going to write this equation over here. A is equal to HFE IB HFE IB RE divided by VS RE divided by VS. Now IB is equal to VS divided by HIE. So this will be HFE and IB is equal to VS divided by HIE into RE divided by VS. Now this will be equal to this VS and VS is going to be cancelled out. So this will be equal to HFE RE divided by HIE. So this is my gain without feedback. So this is my gain without feedback. Now this is my gain without feedback. Now when the feedback is connected, now when I have a feedback connected over here, so this feedback will actually be equal to the V naught. So VF is going to be equal to the V naught, which means that because VF is equal to V naught, I can write over here that VF will be equal to V naught, which means that beta, which is equal to VF divided by V naught, will be equal to 1. So beta is going to be equal to 1. Let me draw a line over here so it's more clear to you. Now let us find the voltage gain with feedback. And that is equal to A divided by 1 plus beta A. And A is my this thing. So I'm going to, in place of A, I'm going to write the gain without feedback. AF will be equal to HFE RE divided by HIE 1 plus, because beta is equal to 1, so I can remove that. So beta is equal to 1. And again A. A is equal to HFE RE divided by HIE. Which means that gain with feedback will be equal to HFE RE divided by HIE. And this will be HIE. HIE plus HFE RE divided by HIE. So this HIE and HIE will cancel out. So we are going to have gain with feedback is equal to HFE RE divided by HIE plus HFE RE. Now normally, so this is my gain with feedback. Now normally HFE RE, this HFE RE is very much greater than this HIE, which is the input impedance or the input resistance of the transistor. So this HFE RE is very much greater than the HIE. So we can write over here, then this will be equal to HFE RE, are approximately equal to, and this can also be written as HFE RE, which means that this will be the voltage gain with feedback is approximately going to be equal to 1. So that is why it is called the emitter follower circuit, because the output follows the input. The output at the emitter follows the input. The output at the emitter is almost equal to the input voltage and is also in phase. So this was voltage series feedback using the BJT, and for that we need the hybrid parameter. We need to remember the hybrid parameter HIE and the small signal current gain R beta, which is equal to HFE. The rest is easy to solve. Thank you.